Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Battle Egg Gamers. Today, we're playing a free game that's on Steam called Monster Inside. You probably guys can see all this, can't you?
You guys see nothing.
But anyway, Monster Inside, an audiovisual novelty by Random Seed Games. I looked into horror games because that's what I'm trying to get into. I actually want to get the bitch out of my system when it comes to horror games. So I found this. I was like, oh, this is nice. Okay. My head pounds, ears still ringing slightly. Some of the worst nightmares I've had in years left me feeling like I've been punched in the jaw. But just by any other day, I've dragged myself to the office. There was another notice in the door from the mayor. I don't care who that is. Permits out of date. They didn't like me much, and they were trying to drown me in paperwork. So it was slow months, weeks since I had any real kids to work on. So I passed the time pacing the office, smoking, staring at the mirror in the corner, safely covered with my own reflection. I don't dare look at my own reflection. I'm too afraid of what I might see. Afraid of one day I might have to face what I really am. Girl came in so quiet. I nearly choked on my cigarette. Girl.
Mister! Please, you gotta help me, mister.
Calm your tits. Alright, show them to me. What's wrong? Yeah, what can I help you with? You ever heard of knocking?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to intrude.
It's alright, sit down and tell me your tale. She eyed me with just a dash of suspicion as I tossed back a handful of pills and chased him down with sweet whiskey. I could tell this might take a while. Her name was Lily. She told me she was his mistress, the man all over the newspaper, the infamous banker, Mr. Ronald Farnsworth. Mr. Farnsworth was a drunk, pedophilia a bastard. But this girl seemed genuinely concerned that he had recently gone missing. Less concerned about the fact that Mr. Farnsworth's wife had just turned up dead in Central Park 2 months ago.
You understand. He just couldn't have done it. He hated his wife. He couldn't have killed her. Everyone thinks him, and no one believes me. He's gotta be in trouble.
Calm your sweet tits. Case this place safer than me. I ain't saying I need you, but what makes you think you can go wrong?
Well, mister,
Jack. Just call me Jack.
Jack, whoever did this to his wife must have been the one who took him. He would never have left without me. He promised me.
Yeah, that's where you got me fucked up. I'm sure Mr. Farnsworth promised this poor girl a lot of things.
Please, the cops won't listen to me, and they're trying to bring him in on charges. You've got to prove it wasn't him before they find him.
Honestly, I doubt they aren't much of a hurry. Farnsworth practically had the entire police force in his deep pocket. Probably why they wouldn't found him much yet. Excuse me. If they found him and brought him in, it would be due to public pressure. Sometimes a mob with a pitchfork is more dangerous than a man with money. You got my curiosity, but you might not like what I find. I can help you. We'll get to the bottom of this, don't you worry. It's
stripping my curiosity.
Thank you, Mr. Jack. Thank you. But please be careful. I don't know. I don't think this is just any normal kidnapping. I think it was a beast.
That's the call me in bed, baby. Beast.
The word struck
me as funny. Like in a jar, your elbow on a hard corner.
Ow! Ow!
That damn got you. Not a word many use these days, except in hushed whispers and bedtime stories for children. Oh. They were real enough, though, alright. They just got better at hiding, controlling their intruding urges. But I hadn't seen any monsters in nearly 15 years. Back when I was still a cop myself. Well, that definitely sounds interesting, theory. I can help you. We'll get to the bottom of this. Don't you worry now. Leave the detective work to me. Let's not judge the conclusion to it. There, if you leave it to me, let me do the detective.
I just have a feeling about it. Something tells me you can get it to the bottom of it. You're good at this sort of thing.
Yeah, sure. Can you see how busy I am with these cases? I replied a little too harsh, so sarcasm isn't my strong suit. It is my strong suit. I reassured her some more and sent her on her way. I didn't want to scare her, but I warned her before she left to keep her doors locked and call me if she saw anything suspicious. I didn't know if she was in any danger herself. That night, I made my way down to Central Park. It was a long shot, but there might be something there that the cops had missed. Next chapter.
Alright guys, well, I'm going to end the episode here. Okay, that was good. I'm actually into this. I like stories and games. It's kind of my forte. I really like them. But when the end of the episode here, there's actually 7 chapters in this game, so we just finished the first one, apparently. I guess it's just all clicking stuff. So, if you guys want to see the story all the way to the end, please let me know in the comments below. Make sure you guys share this with your fellow friends and your veterans, mainly the veterans, because that's how I made the channel for them. So, anyway, see you guys next time on Red Light Games. Fire the cannon! You guys take care.